Hi, everybody. Welcome to my newest video. I'm actually a little nervous today, which is unusual. I think I never plan my videos in advance, but I have usually a couple of thoughts. Let them evolve organically in front of the camera. But today, I just have really one topic, and I have no idea how it's going to express itself. I want to take a moment to kind of ground myself. I'm still outside in my lovely backyard, but in a different section. So I have a view of different scenery, another lovely tree that is bigger branches that are moving in the wind. I can turn my head and see the sky. And there's a really lovely breeze that is very revitalizing, really. Yeah, I could stronger breeze today than during my last two videos that were outside. That will help keep me awake and grounded. And I'm happy with my new stage setup. The setup is becoming, set design is becoming my new art medium, though I have a professional set designer. She's also a makeup artist it's really her work, but I get to contribute, and it really inspires me. The message of my videos, I think, is the most important, but the artistic piece is what infuses me with so much joy, because I love color and I love to create artistic things. So these videos allow me to combine so many aspects of myself. Another deep breath as I slowly settle into this video. Just kind of really getting myself in my body. Easy way to do that is to really just feel your breath as it goes in and out, noting where it is in the body. It's a really easy and quick way to ground yourself. I'm guessing that part of the reason I'm nervous also is because I have a difficult topic to talk about. Since the last time I spoke with all of you, I've been diagnosed with tumors in both of my eyes, as well as a small tumor in the lining of my brain. And as you can imagine, this has been devastating news, and also a very exhausting process to get clarity on exactly what the nature of the medical issues, and then to decide on proper treatment. So I'm kind of, it was two crazy weeks of testing. Honestly, it's kind of like a blur. I kind of feel like I can't even remember parts of the last 2 weeks. I had to get, a brain MRI, an eye MRI, a brain CT scan. I was fortunate to be able to go to San Francisco and meet with a renowned eye specialist. He had to meet with a radiologist. Every day was some major, major, major testing and multiple doctors, and it was very stressful and highly exhausting. The good news, if you can say that there's good news, is that breast cancer that has metastasized to the eyes is very treatable. It is one of the most treatable forms of eye cancer. Most eye cancers are, particularly melanoma and many other eye cancers, are very, very difficult to treat. Breast cancer is very responsive to treatment, which is radiation, and most often the tumors are permanently eradicated. So that's the good news. I started radiation yesterday, and it will be 4 weeks of radiation Monday through Friday. And I took a day off already to shoot my video because I'm so committed to launching my website, and the videos are a significant part of how I get my message out. It's interesting because my website will have letters, 5 years worth of letters, or 6 years now, that document in detail my 6 year, I don't know why I don't like the word battle, 6 year battle, my 6 year journey with cancer. And I feel so blessed because when I wrote those letters, I was just writing them for my own survival. And they're like this well of wealth that I can now tap into that gives the background for my whole current struggle. That it would have been very hard to document the past 6 years in retrospect, and I don't have to. So the letters will be there, and I'll have an art therapy section, because I've done a great deal of art throughout this whole process. And of course there'll be the video blog and a written blog and a poetry section and a treatment section. Shouldn't leave out that, a comprehensive treatment section documenting both the conventional and alternative treatments that I've integrated into my treatment plan. So it's a big baby. And I pretty much live for the opportunity to complete this task. And it's also fun. But the video part is the most fun because it's not laborious. For me, it's just fun. I joke that I get to be a star for a day because I go and get my hair done, and then my makeup artist comes, who also does set design, and she helps me with wardrobe, and I don't plan anything, so I get to be spontaneous. There's no element of work. It's just a day of fun for me. Whereas the other elements of my website are meaningful and purposeful and sometimes fun, but there's an element of labor, because when you're, you know, editing 200 letters, you know, that's work, because you got to read them, and it's a lot of left brain, and I still love it. But the videos are pure joy. And so that's why I didn't want to stop them just because I was going through radiation. So I'll have today's video, which kind of marks the beginning of radiation. And then I'll have another video in 2 weeks, which will be halfway through radiation, which will, I'm guessing by the halfway mark, I'm going to be pretty tired of radiation, so taking a break and doing something fun for a day will probably give me the energy and the motivation to kind of get over the hump and make it through the last couple weeks of radiation. And it's kind of interesting because I didn't plan these video dates after I got my diagnosis. I planned them many, many weeks ago because there's so many people that I have to coordinate with, but the timing of them worked out perfectly. And it was suggested by a friend that I not give up my video during the time of radiation, that I hold on to what's most important to me and find a way to do both. And my doctor supported me in this. And so here I am. The radiation, it's hard for me because it's such a sterile environment. It's so not like my nature. I come in and I lie down and they strap my head in so I can't move my head. And they have a mask that they made of my face, molds to my face, and they cut out the eyes and they put the mask on and they clamp the mask to the thing that's holding my head in place, and they roll me into the CT scanner. And then there's this equipment, I don't even know what it's called, but there's I feel like I'm in outer space, or like in some kind of robot land, because there's these big machines with it's got these arms and it moves and it makes sounds, and not like loud sounds like an MRI, but just like there's this equipment moving around me, and the people who are assisting actually leave the room. So if I need help, I'm just supposed to raise my left hand, strapped in with the thing over my helmet and the mask. And if I need assistance, that's how I let them know. I raise my left hand and we had one of our vases fell. Do you want to?
Just keep going.
We'll keep going. Stuart, my video man, says keep going. So we'll keep going. Let's see. So the process is not pleasant. It lasts about 15 minutes. And again, it's just not, it's hard. You can't find nature. You can't find softness. It's very, you know, that being said, I have to remember that this sterile metal clamping down equipment, robotic environment is also going to save my vision. So I don't like saying radiation because radiation sounds so heavy and depressing. Just the word, especially I've already gone through radiation. The first time I was diagnosed, I had radiation on my right breast. So the whole word is heavy and depressing again to me. So I decided to call it, I don't know if I can remember what I said. The wind is blowing. I hope no more vases or things in my setup drop, but that's okay. We'll go with it. Oh, let's see. I can't remember. Shoot. Let's see. Brightening your world treatments. That's what it was. So I came up with the name that's not depressing, because I think it's kind of obvious. Your eyes, when you can see, your world is brighter. When you can't see, it's not so bright. So I renamed it to say, instead of saying I'm going for my radiation treatment, I say I'm going to my Brighten Your World treatment. And that doesn't minimize, you know, the discomfort and the disappointment and the struggle, but it just it's also important to remember why I'm doing it. And I chose the radiation because I didn't see many choices. One was I could say I'm done and commit suicide. I mean, it's a choice, but I don't really feel ready. That's not a choice that I resonate with at this point in time. I could do nothing, and I would likely watch myself go blind, pun intended, or I could have the radiation, which, you know, there's always a risk, but the risk is very small and the probability of success is very high. And I really don't want to be blind, and I really can't complete my mission, what I see as my life mission, if I can't see, because I'm all about, you know, creating, and you need eyes. Well, you don't need eyes. I mean, Stevie Wonder creates, he's blind. I mean, but I need eyes for what I do. So that's the choice I made. The tumor, small tumor, in the lining of my brain will also need radiation, but a much smaller duration, probably 1 to 4 treatments. And I don't know the logistics of that. We're kind of gonna get the radiation on the eyes, you know, rolling, which we already did, started yesterday. And as that progresses, more concrete decisions will be made about what to do with the tumor, small tumor, in the lining of my brain. It is, the eye tumors are not new. So it's not that the cancer has metastasized into a new area. I noticed significant loss of vision in my right eye about the time that I was diagnosed with metastatic cancer. I didn't think much of it, but the loss became so significant that I knew something was wrong. And I brought my concerns to one of my doctors, who I won't name. I don't name any people in my videos or on my website. And he checked my eyes and said, you know, everything looks fine to me. And I brought it to his attention 2 times. And both times he dismissed my concerns and reassured me that everything was okay. And so I didn't act. I didn't take prompt action. And finally, it was very bizarre. Finally, one day I was getting blood drawn and there were these beautiful sunflowers that were small. And I'd never really seen small sunflowers before. And something inspired me to look at the flowers like this. And I saw beautiful yellow sunflowers. And then I went like this, and the sunflowers were white. And I freaked out. And I said, you're acting now. Like, you know, you are acting now. And I said, I went home, I went on the internet, and I found, you know, someone to look at my eyes, you know, within 48 hours after seeing sunflowers white. That was enough for me. That in itself is very interesting because I look back and I say, what on earth would possess me? I mean, I'm casually sitting in the waiting room of a place where they we go to have blood drawn. You know, they're sunflowers. What on earth would possess me to look at them individually with each eye? And I think the answer to that question is kind of a heavenly nature. I believe that there's a force in this universe that that tries to give us information, but it's not a in a real direct way. It doesn't say, hey, you have eye tumors, go to the eye doctor, go see a radiologist, but it sends these impulses that you don't even really realize that you've received it to do what I did. So something had to cause me to do that. It's a, and the more grounded you are and the more connected to spirit, the more these subtle impulses that really, it's hard to almost differentiate them from yourself because they come in so naturally and you just respond to them. And it's only if you step back and reflect that you can become aware that there's some other energy that is trying to point you in the right direction, that is in support of your life. And then I looked back on my most recent paintings and I see an eye and I see a tumor. I mean, so from my subconscious, from, you know, external energetic forces, something internally and something externally greater than me was really trying to get my attention to say, this needs to be addressed, and this needs to be addressed now. And I'm grateful that I was in calm and grounded enough spirit to finally receive that input, which allowed me to take action. So that is, you know, an update of my a big breath of my most recent medical condition, and it's been rough, and I'm still committed to my sole purpose, and I'm just going to do the best I can. I don't feel I can leave this earth in peace until my website is launched. The website is becoming far more, it's far more than about cancer. It's really a lifetime of work that I'm not taking to my grave. It's too heavy. But it's light when I put it out. When I transform it and put it out into the world, it's light and it brings light. If I keep it in and take it to my grave, my spirit will leave this realm with a great weight. And I don't want that weight. And I also want the world, in whatever way they can, to benefit from my very long journey in life, and then most recently with cancer. So I want to thank all of you who have supported me on this journey. I am, right now I'm still sharing with my inner circle, though all these videos will be posted they already are posted on my website, but my website is not complete and it's not viewable to the public yet. I'm hoping 6 months is my goal to have enough of it in place to launch it with the vision that I have for it. I don't really want to compromise on my vision. So I'm taking my time to do it in the way that feels right. And I'm asking God or the universe to please support me in giving me the time to complete my work. And if they want to give me time beyond that, I'll certainly take it. But right now, I just want, my focus is on launching this website, of which the videos are a significant component and a great joy for me. So I feel like I'm at a good concluding point. You will be hearing from me again in 2 weeks, and I will be able to update you on how the radiation is going and any plans for the brain radiation. I'm going to take in this beautiful tree again and feel the breeze and take in a glimpse of the blue sky and all the things. Oh, that breeze feels so good. And all the things that revitalize me. Everything about nature is so revitalizing. And I'm going to think how any concluding remarks I would like to make. So I'm going to pause for a moment and breathe and focus on where my breath is going. So I want to give thanks for this amazingly beautiful day. I want to give thanks that in the middle of a very, very difficult time, that I can have a day that's infused with joy. I want to give thanks that I have really, really qualified medical support for the most recent challenge, which is the eye and the brain tumors. I want to give thanks to all the people who have supported me, friends, family, my inner circle, medical professionals, and the team of people who work on helping my website launch, from my video man, who's here right now, obviously, and the editor who edits these videos, who works with him, and my Beth Alice, she does wardrobe, makeup, and set design, and my editor who is editing all my writing, and my website designer. So all the people who are, the team of people who are supporting me in getting my work and my website launched. I want to give thanks to the breeze and nature. Mostly I just want to give thanks again for the possibility to feel genuine joy during such a difficult time. So thank you again for all of your support, and I will look forward to tuning in again with all of you in 2 weeks. Blessings and deep gratitude.